Good, good. We got a wedding coming up in about an hour now. You were in a little different position here not too much longer ago. Remember that one?
I remember.
Yeah.
Except I was probably a little more relaxed, but I'm pretty relaxed.
Well, that's good. I'd like to ask you just a few questions if we can, just kind of all in fun or whatever, just kind of jump in. Do you remember where you and Tracy met for the first time?
I worked at a sorority And I just met her when at the sorority.
Mm-hmm.
I don't exactly remember the first time. I remember the first time we probably ever really talked a whole lot.
Uh-huh.
I was cooking hamburgers for a lot of the girls. And
yeah.
I remember I was actually there to check out all the new freshman class that had come up and was getting
sent by the fraternity to check it out, or
no? I was working there at the sorority. I was the houseboy.
Okay.
And I had offered to cook hamburgers for all the little pledges one night.
Uh-huh.
All the sisters, and she was in charge of that, of getting all that together. And And that's probably the first time I really talked to her a whole lot.
Do you remember your first impression, or was there any real first impression then, or just kind of...
No, there wasn't.
We just kind of talked and passed along, eh?
That first time, yeah. There wasn't really any first impression at all. It kind of...
After that time, how long did it take you before you finally got together, maybe to go out on a date or meet
someone?
Probably
only a week or so, a couple of weeks.
Yeah. Remember where you went the first time, first date?
Sure. A place called Steve Marino's.
Uh-huh. Have a good time?
Yeah, we had a good time.
Good, good.
Had a great time.
Anything memorable about that night? Did y'all really hit it off, or, you know?
Yeah, we had a great time. And she tried to kiss me across the table. Ooh. On our first date.
Uh-huh.
She tried to kiss me.
Yeah.
Very aggressive woman.
Well, tried now. Did she succeed?
See, she came across the table at me, and I went, whoop! And she caught me on the cheek. She was very upset. I really humiliated her.
Uh-huh. Were y'all by yourselves or with somebody?
Oh, we were by ourselves.
Oh, so everybody was watching this and humiliated, right?
Well, I don't know if anybody was watching.
Okay, let's go to a little bit later that night. Did you try to kiss her later that night? Was there ever a first kiss that night?
Well, yeah, probably so. Probably later on there was.
Good. How long ago was this when y'all first met?
When we first met, it was early October.
Yeah. So y'all been dating for how long?
So, what, October, November, December, January, February, a year and 5 months.
Okay, good, good. During that time, have you found any real thing y'all like to do together? Any place you like to go, or, you know, your special place or special times?
Probably not much. We, as far as special times go, we just like to... be at home together.
Uh-huh.
And just talk.
Just enjoy each other's company?
Exactly.
Well, that's great. That's great. During the time that y'all been dating, if you had to put your finger on something, was there a particular time when y'all were together that you said, hey, Tracy's the girl I want to spend the rest of my life with? Or maybe something she's done for you?
There's probably the fact that she just made me a better person in the way that she made me strive to do my best and all that I wanted to do.
Good.
If there was something I needed to do or had to do, she pushed me and encouraged me no matter what it was that I wanted to do.
Uh-huh.
And just helped me achieve the things that I wanted to achieve.
Great, great. If you had to describe Tracy, how would you describe her?
I would say that she is confident. She very hardworking in her job, and very responsible. Sometimes she takes on too much responsibility and tries to do too much to make things go right. Because I'm a real laid back personality, and she's the real active personality where she's just going all the time and talking a lot. So
yeah, have y'all talked about
real nice.
Yeah? Have y'all talked about a family down the road?
Possibly, as soon as we can afford it.
What would you like to see down the road?
I'd like to see children in no more than 4 years would be nice.
Yeah. How many?
Well, one in 4 years, maybe two in five.
Boys or girls, or does it matter?
It doesn't really matter.
Okay. What's Tracy going to tell me?
What is she going to tell
you? Yeah, what's she going to tell me on how many kids?
I don't know. I just want two would be fine with me.
Good, good. Okay.
I think she'll tell you two.
Okay. This is the hardest question I'm going to ask you. When you answer it, I want you to look right in here. You probably already know what this question
is. Yeah, I remember watching this question.
What's it going to take to make this marriage work? Right here, you're talking to Tracy.
It's going to take trust and a lot of love and always being open with each other and just growing together in a Christian home and raising a Christian family, where we're always open and always communicating with each other.
Good, good answer. Where are you going on honeymoon?
Jamaica.
Good, leaving out tonight or tomorrow?
No, actually we're going to go back to Atlanta and work for a week and then go because the high season's in right now and all they offer is seven-day vacations. Uh-huh. And we didn't want to go for a whole 7 days, so we're just going for 4 days.
Hey, for 4 days leaving out. Okay. Well, you know, I usually give you a warning, check your bags, because you never know what your friends are going to do before you leave. But I don't guess I have to warn you of that. You know, they take your clothes and put bricks in place of it or whatever.
Well.
But we're not going to have to worry about that tonight.
No.
Close out the last question I want to ask you, or what I want to offer you an opportunity. Look right in here, and anything else you'd like to tell Tracy.
I love you.
Play-by-play description of what we're doing here, folks.
We're getting rid of my blotches.
Getting okay.
The dress itches, and we're
anti-itchy. It's an itchy dress. That's true.
Anti-itchy.
It's very itchy.
Very itchy.
The inside, the entire inside.
You know,
I'm going to be in a terrible blotches
Ma'am,
tonight.
That looks good.
Yeah.
It's not red.
I'm hysterical. What happened? Just the nerves?
I didn't like my hair this morning.
Oh, well, it looks fine.
It looks better now.
I'd like to ask you just a couple of questions. These are kind of fun. I don't know if you've seen any of the previous tape. We've changed the questions just for y'all. So, anyway, some of them will be the same. Remember where you and your groom first met?
Mm-hmm.
Where was it?
It was at the sorority house.
Uh-huh. What was the occasion?
He was cooking hamburgers for me.
For you?
For me.
Great, great. Is that the only reason? Did he come over to see you or something? Is that what happened?
No, he's a houseboy at the sorority house.
Oh, okay, all right.
And he was cooking hamburgers because I had a date that night with someone else.
Oh, really?
And he was helping me so I wouldn't be late for my date.
I see. So y'all were cooking together, I guess. Okay.
Well, I was watching. I don't cook. He cooks.
Why would he come over and cook?
He's at the sorority house. He's the houseboy.
Yeah.
And so he had to help with dinner.
Okay.
He had to, like, do the dishes and stuff.
How many were y'all cooking for?
150 people.
150? That's a lot of hamburgers.
Yep.
I bet the thought of going to the Crystal Pasture at least once or twice.
A couple of times.
Did you hit it off right away that first night with him, even though you had another date? Was there still a thought going through your mind that, hey, I really don't want to go out?
I told my little sister in sorority that was the guy that I wanted to go out with him, and that was the guy I was going to marry.
Is that right? This first night. So how long did it take you to entrap him?
6 months.
6 months.
It took Ken a little while to get with the program.
After that first night that y'all were together cooking hamburgers, how long did it take you to go out on a date after that?
About a week.
Who called who? Or how did you go out? How'd you happen to go out?
We disagree about this, but I was afraid that the guy that I had been going out with, that he was going to stand me up.
Uh-huh.
And I'd gotten all upset about it. And Ken had told me, well, you know, no big deal. If he does, we'll rent movies. Well, Sean didn't stand me up. And so the next day I called Ken to tell him that I was sorry. And I asked him out for that night. And
Where'd you go?
We went to Steve Reno's.
Good. Good. Have a good time.
Yeah. And I gave him our first kiss.
Really?
I kissed him.
At the restaurant or?
At the restaurant.
Let me ask, what were you doing?
It was outside.
Were you dancing or something?
No, we were having a pitcher of beer.
Pitcher of beer and you had I tell you, ladies just can't handle your beer, can you? So, did he respond?
No, he turned his back.
Did he really? How long? Well, if he turned his face, did you actually kiss him?
Yeah, okay. I got another chance.
Did he return the response later on?
He returned the response. Good.
After that first date, I assume you must have really hit it off pretty well.
We hit it off.
And it's been about how long since y'all been dating to today?
A year and about 4 months.
4 months, okay. Mm-hmm. During that time, has there been a particular moment or something that y'all have done together or something he's done for you that's really told you, hey, this is the guy I want to spend the rest of my life with?
There's been a lot of things.
Well, maybe one or two.
No, they're embarrassing.
No, go ahead. That's what this is all about.
When he bought me personal items that men don't like to buy for women, then I knew when he went to the grocery store. Then I knew.
Aisle number 7, row B, right? Okay, I won't go any further with that one. Have y'all talked about a family down the road?
Yeah, it'll be a while.
What would you like to see? Eventually.
I'd like to see two. I'd like to see twins that will just get it over with.
Boys,
all at once.
Girls, boys, or what?
A boy and a girl.
Okay. Walk through here. We had to get take care of. Yeah. During the time that y'all have been dating, I guess there's been maybe some special times you've had together. Is there one thing maybe y'all like to do together and be together doing? You know, someplace you might like to go out to eat or places you like to go, something like that you just enjoy together?
I'm more of a homebody. I want to stay at home and watch movies. And
okay.
He wants to go out with a big crowd of friends.
What kind of movies do you like to watch?
Well, he does like romantic movies.
Oh, he does?
I had never seen Out of Africa. Uh-huh. And he rented it for us, and yeah. We watched that.
Good, good. Hardest question I'm going to ask you. You know what it is if you've already seen the tape. I want you to look right in here, and I want you to tell him, what's it going to take to make this marriage work?
Well, I told Ken this when we were talking about getting married, and I told him that as long as we put the Lord first, then everything else would be fine. That was just the main thing. We needed to put God first, and we'd be okay.
That's a good answer. Real good answer. Good. Anything else you'd like to tell Ken?
As long as we just have patience, and if we when and if we get mad at each other, just take time and be patient. And like I said, if you put the Lord first.
Yeah. Going on honeymoon?
Going on honeymoon.
Where are you going?
Going to Jamaica.
Good. That's not what he told me. No, I'm kidding. He did tell me that. When are y'all leaving?
We're not leaving for a week.
For a week. Okay. I understand y'all going to go back and do a little working and then go.
Yeah, a little working first.
Got to save a little money to go. I understand. I understand that perfectly. Is there any last thing you'd like to tell Ken before we close out?
I'd just like to tell him that when he proposed, he asked me to be his.
something else comes up in your really life, I take that.
Thank you. Dearly beloved, we're gathered together here in the sight of God, in the presence of these witnesses, family, and friends, to join together Ken and Tracy in holy matrimony, which is an honorable institution which God has blessed and given to us for the fulfillment of our human nature and our maturity. It signifies unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and His church. And Christ blessed the marriage in Cana of Galilee, as you will recall from John's Gospel, with His presence. It's therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. And in this holy institution, Tracy and Ken come now to be joined. And I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are disclosed, that having duly considered the holy covenant you're about to make, you do now declare your pledge of faith each to the other. Be well assured that if these solemn vows are kept inviolate, as God's word demands, if you steadfastly endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, then God will bless your marriage, He will grant you fulfillment in it, and He will establish your home in peace. Ken, wilt thou have Tracy to be thy wedded wife, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Tracy, wilt thou have Ken to be thy wedded husband, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto him so long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Who presenteth Tracy to be married to Ken?
Her mother and I do.
From the 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. So faith, hope, love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. I can. Take thee, Tracy.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. And thereto I pledge thee my faith. I, Tracy.
Take thee, Ken.
To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance. And thereto I pledge thee my faith. The wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying the uniting of Tracy and Ken together in holy matrimony through the church of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving and wearing of these rings, that they who give them and wear them may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
In token and pledge
of our constant faith
and abiding love
with this ring
I thee wed
in the name of the Father
and of the Son
and of the Holy Spirit
Amen.
In token and pledge
of our constant faith
and abiding love
with this ring
I thee wed
in the name of the Father
and of the Son
and of the Holy Spirit
Amen. Let us join our hearts together in prayer. Our Father, we come before you on this blessed day, recognizing that you are the creator and sustainer of life, and you created us in your image. You created us male and female with the capacity to love one another and to commit ourselves to one another in love and fidelity for life. And we pray now that you would send your Holy Spirit to unite Ken and Tracy in holy matrimony. Wed them together, that they no longer shall be twain, but one. We ask your blessing upon the marriage and the home, the blessing upon whatsoever offsprings you give to them. We pray that you would always be their unseen guest at every table, that you will be with them during the difficult times, the times of stress and struggle, just as you are with them during the glad times as well. Grant to them, O God, your peace that passeth all understanding, that they may be one in their commitment to you, their commitment to their marriage, their commitment to one another. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Forasmuch as Ken and Tracy have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other and declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. What God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Let us pray. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord graciously with his favor look upon you and so fill you with all spiritual benediction and love that you may so live together in this world that in the world to come you may have life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
do it now?
Yeah, I got one. They better be perfect because I told everyone that they're going to be perfect. They're perfect children.
So an advance warning.
Yeah, advance warning. They better be perfect.
That's right. You got a great mom and dad, so behave.
Please don't ask her.
you like to wish the bride and groom anything?
Just a happy, happy forever.
Good, good.
A lovely life together.
Good. Well, let me get you here. Now repeat that.
No, don't do it.
No. We got that. Yes, absolutely. Let me ask you, you've been married for how long?
31 years this summer.
Okay, if you had to offer them a little word of advice, what does it take to make a marriage work? What would you tell them? Great. Okay, good. Would you like to offer to that? What does it take?
Before you're awake in the morning, don't discuss anything serious. Only, I love you. That's all you're allowed to say before.
Go get your coffee first, right? Okay, all right. Good. Thank y'all. How you doing, gentlemen? Good. Introduce yourself.
I'm Jim McAllister.
Good. And this is?
My name is Bo Murphy. How you doing?
Good. And you are?
David Garrison.
Good, good. Anything you'd like? Pardon?
I said it's a great wish.
Sure was. Anything y'all would like to wish the bride and the groom?
Oh, the best of luck.
Good. Okay.
The best of luck.
Oh, yeah.
Good. Y'all three married?
Right.
Yeah. Each of you tell me, what does it take to make a marriage work?
A lot of give and take.
Okay.
Good sense.
Okay.
I just hope they'll be half as happy as my wife and I thought we were going to be.
Great. Thank the bride and the groom.
Oh, is this on video?
Yes, it is.
We wish them all the happiness in the world.
Great.
We sure do.
Good.
Nobody step on this, please.
Oh, yeah. That's good. Here we go. One, two, three, four, one, two, three.
Did you blink? Everybody saw the light?
Let's do it one more time. One, two, three.
How are you?
Good.
Introduce yourself.
Hi,
son, Tracy, his grandma.
Great, great. How'd you enjoy the wedding?
It was beautiful.
Good, good.
Glad it's over.
Any little stories about the granddaughter?
Not all right, I don't think. I got to think that. You know, I have two younger granddaughters.
Good, good.
I think the things we'd like to tell, I can remember those a lot better than the older time.
Okay.
Because that doll, she's down to what, 23?
Oh, good. Is there any little words of wisdom you'd like to convey to Tracy and Ken?
Just be happy and love one another.
Great. Okay, good. Thank you very much, Shel.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Hi, Tracy. Hope you and Ken have a great life together, and we're glad to be here.
How do you know them?
Oh, okay. I used to go to church with Tracy a long, long time ago.
Good.
And then I lived down the street from him.
Uh-huh.
So.
Is there anything that Ken ought to know about Tracy?
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, she what?
She talks a lot.
All right, okay. And you are?
I live down the street from her, too. She stayed at my house a lot.
Good, good, okay.
As a matter of fact, she used to call me Mom.
Any best wishes or words of wisdom? Good. Okay. Anything you'd like to add?
Have a great life together. I think you guys made an excellent decision. It'd be great for each other.
Good. Okay. Thank you. Why are y'all leaving?
We have lunch.
You've had enough of that cake, right?
Yeah.
Any best wishes you'd like to convey to the bride and the groom?
Don't kiss tomorrow when I pick up at 1.
I don't know what.
Any best wishes?
Well, no.
I would allow them to kiss at 1 o'clock.
Okay.
Happy birthday.
It's
my birthday.
Is it your birthday? Yeah. Hey, well, happy birthday to you. Good.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Introduce yourself.
Introduce myself.
And how do you relate to the wedding? Friend of the bridegroom, a relative, or what? Go ahead.
My name is Todd Kegler.
Okay.
I'm the sexual partner of the groom. No, I'm really.
Okay, we'll come back. We'll come back to that. Go ahead.
That was a little deep.
Don't even ask.
You know what I mean?
Introduce yourself.
I'm the brother of the groom, obviously.
Yeah, and your name is?
David.
Good. Okay.
I'm Troy Wilson, friend of the groom's.
Okay, great. Any little stories about the bride and the groom you like to convey, bride or groom, or going to school, growing up, whatever? Keep reasonably clean.
You got any thoughts on Pam real quick?
I don't know, some she's important.
Oh, yeah.
She's got a bad temper.
Pardon?
She's got a very bad temper. One night when they were having, what was that party? Is there a
graduation?
Oh, she.
No, it wasn't a graduation.
Yes,
was
it?
Good. While they're bickering, you go ahead.
Graduation party.
See, we were right.
His old condo, Ken's current condo, well, his past condo.
Old condo.
Old condo. And they were like in the kitchen, and she had a friend.
Kitchen.
She had like a friend that I think that you and Mike were hitting on.
No.
They were hitting
on
anyway,
and she was getting upset
about it.
She didn't
like it. She was getting
upset. Like ice cream trays, threw me in the face, ice all over. She took off out.
Yeah, ice trays went everywhere. Water everywhere.
As a brother, is there anything Tracy ought to know about her new husband? What now? Speak up.
He's a bedwetter.
He's impotent.
What was she? She probably knows more better than I.
And growing up, was there anything? Did you ever think he was going to get married?
He was the first one picked out of all the boys to get married.
We figured he'd get married first. He's more of a laid-back personality. He's more of a serious talk.
Okay. All right.
He's always a ladies' man. Always had a steady girlfriend.
Okay. Now you were related how?
Just a friend of the...
Just a friend. From school or what?
About the 8th grade. About the 8th grade.
Okay, all right. Any school stories?
No, they got in a lot of trouble. I went to another school, yeah.
You got
in a lot of trouble.
What'd you get in trouble
after
for?
After graduation.
What'd you get in trouble for?
Ken threw a huge party. It was his idea, and he kind of blamed it on me and Dave.
Where was the party?
At Mom and Daddy Knowles' house.
Oh, they knew about it now.
No, they didn't know about it.
They didn't know
about
it.
They went out of town, you know.
Do they know about it now?
Yeah, they know about it.
Okay.
And we got in a lot of trouble. And so did Ken, but he kind of put it back on us. And it was his main idea, you know, to have a party.
All right.
It was his fault, too, because he left all the cans.
He was always good at getting out of trouble.
Yeah, he was.
Because he was the laid-back one, and he would never argue back with me. He'd always say, yeah, Mom, Dad, yeah, Mom, Dad. So,
okay.
So they always were easier on him.
Any best wishes you'd like to convey to him?
I hope he has a happy honeymoon, has a good life. I'm happy for him. Hope his t-shirt business comes out very good.
Any best wishes?
Well, first of all, I'm very glad to
speak up.
First of all, I'm very glad to have another member of the family. My sister just got married back in April, so I just got another brother. And now Ken gets married, so now I have another sister, so the family's expanding.
That's right.
So I'm really honored to have Tracy as a sister.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to spending a lot of time with
her. Might be an uncle pretty soon. Who knows?
Yeah. Well, Amy will be the first, so.
Okay. Any best wishes?
I'd just like to say it's been an honor to be in the wedding room. I enjoyed it. I wish both of them all the happiness in the world and a lot of success in your business. And I'm not going to show this to Ken.
We want free t-shirts.
I want,
Ken,
no, we all love you. I want him to become the newspaper boy of the week.
Yeah, he is up here.
Newspaper boy of the week.
He is
Fortune
up there.
Magazine.
He did throw 72% into the patio last week.
Into the patio.
But we want him to get a hairstyle like Dave.
Yeah, like this. See, the kind of the...
little moose?
The moose look. He needs a moose look. His hair is too
Ken's
flat.
Ken's the only one in the family with bangs. Man.
Yeah, he's got bangs, you know. Ken's,
you get rid of those bangs,
Ken's hair is kind of down like this. Yeah.
Okay, gentlemen, everybody say goodbye.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Hi, folks.
Hey.
Oh, I'll step out of the way. Any best wishes y'all would like to convey to the bride and the groom?
No,
I'll follow you. If you keep backing up, I'll just keep following, so don't back up. Introduce yourselves. You are?
Nina.
Jimmy.
Jimmy, y'all just together, married, or what?
No. We're just together right now.
Just together, okay. Any best wishes you'd like to convey to him?
Just best wishes.
No, you can't use those words. Anything?
Jimmy, it's you. It's
I am
you
not good on the spot. I'll tell you what. I clam up. I am not.
How about? Good luck.
Okay. Good luck. Okay, let's pray.
Good luck.
All right. One time. One, okay. Two, three. Go.
Good luck.
Good luck.
I'm fine.
How'd you enjoy the wedding?
It was lovely.
Great.
She was a beautiful bride, and she couldn't have found a more handsome one. He's my grandson.
Great, great. Tracy and Ken, we wish you all the luck in the world. Good, good. And he's your grandson.
That's right.
Right?
Our
Is
grandson.
There anything Tracy ought to know about Ken?
She already knows a good bit about him.
Okay, great. Thank y'all very much.
Okay.
How y'all doing?
Great.
Good, good. For all of those that don't know, he's standing right behind you there.
That's my dad.
That's right. Any little stories you'd like to convey?
Well, I'll tell you one story, Tracy and Ken, that we found out when we got married. First time we got in an argument, all of a sudden realized you can't stomp your feet and go home and let it all settle down and then argue it out. You kind of stuck together in the same house, so you need to just be patient and work it all out. And I'm not saying you'll have a lot of arguments, but the key word is patience. When you get married, it takes a lot of that and a lot of love to work through life together.
Ken, I'll give you more advice, I guess, from my side. My full 10 months of marriage, what can I say? Just a little bit. Flowers, every once in a while, never hurt.
She gives you flowers?
Yeah, she gives me flowers.
Nice.
It really makes me feel great. Always look around the house. If anything's changed, make a comment on it, say how good it was, or, you know, anything like
that. Is that regardless?
And keep on cooking, literally.
Right, right.
You can stay in the kitchen.
Is she a good cook?
She can cook,
I am,
right.
But Tracy's not.
Okay, Tracy's not a good cook.
So Ken needs to keep
okay.
Ken, learn your phone number. If you're ever more than 15 minutes late, you better call. Okay? And let me tell you something else, too. If you forget to call and you went out and ate with the guys and you come home and there's some special meal, eat twice that night. And don't say anything else. Just say how great it was.
Has that happened before?
Oh, never with
you
me.
You made that mistake
never
one time, right?
Also, one other bit of advice. If your wife goes out of town for the weekend and you happen to stumble in the house after a long night with the guys about 2:25 and the phone rings at 2:30, sound very tired and say you went to bed at 10 o'clock. Everything will be fine, I promise you.
That's it. We love y'all and best of luck.
Who's the boss?
She is. She is. Yeah.
Okay, great. Thank y'all very much.
$50.
Let's hear it, girls. Let's hear it. Arms out. On what it takes to make a marriage work, each of you.
A lot of give and take.
Okay.
A lot of give and take, right.
Great. Okay. Yes. Thank you all.
Yes. Not a lot.
I'm sorry?
Understanding.
Good. And you are?
Jelly Waller.
Good. Okay. Friends of the bride, groom, or relative, or what?
Ken and Tracy.
That's the bride and the groom.
Yes, there you go. The bride and groom.
Okay. How do you know them?
I'm through Eric Stein. He's right over there. Get him. He's right there.
Okay. All right. Anything you'd like to wish the bride and the groom?
I wish them. I'm not going to say that.
Yeah, you can say it. Go ahead.
A great sex life.
Great, okay. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'm going to embarrass you here now. What does it take to do that?
You were using your understanding.
There you go. All right.
can I say something?
Yes, I'm working.
I want to say something to Tracy. Tracy, I planned her bachelorette party at the Lemon Peel. I don't want to say, Tracy, you know, can they be...
She went to the Lemon Peel for a bachelorette party?
Yeah.
No.
She was a lot.
Tell me about how she acted at the Lemon Peel.
Well, let me tell you, let me just sum it up in this, okay? Tracy, you know, can maybe know Santana, but he's up there, and I think he's a great guy, and I wish you guys a lot of love and happiness in your marriage.
How much money did she give to Santana?
There were so many dollar bills flying around, I couldn't keep count.
Santana was a man.
You notice how she said was?
Is. It'll always be.
So in other words, who's getting married next, or when are we going back to the Lemon Peel?
I don't know.
Well, they know me by name there, so I guess I'll edit that.
Okay. Thank you, Albert. And how do you relate to the wedding?
I'm Trudy Smith, and I was a bridesmaid, and I was Tracy's roommate in Atlanta from about August until a couple of nights ago.
Not anymore.
That's right.
Right. Okay.
I'm Amy Kilpatrick. I'm Tracy's new sister. I'm Ken's sister.
Okay.
I'm Claire Coward. I'm Tracy's maid of honor, and Tracy and I have known each other since fifth grade, and we went to summer camp together.
Okay.
I'm Kim Reagan, and I met Tracy at Georgia. We both pledged Gamma Phi Beta at the same time. I'm sorry, sisters.
Okay, good. Any little stories about the bride and the groom?
I got one about 11 o'clock this morning. Tracy, I don't want you to ever forget going, I hate my bangs. She had a big cry of her
hair. I heard she had a little problem.
And wasn't she the most beautiful bride?
She was. She told me she had already gone through that fit this morning. She didn't go into it, what had happened, but she just said she had a problem. Anything?
Yes.
Now, being roommates has got, all right. We'll come over here. Camp stories.
Let's see. Camp stories.
Is it true what happens at summer camp? Is it really like the movie?
Well, this was a church camp now, so I mean, this very clean, very clean.
Were the boys across the lake and the girls on this?
No, actually, you know, we're up on separate camp hills or whatever. But let's see. I'll pass. Go to camp.
When we went on the bachelorette party, there was one guy at the Lemon Peel that she went crazy over.
Santana.
Oh, my God. We would hold dollars up, and she'd go, no, he's not coming yet. And then he'd look at her, or he'd start walking her way, dollars. And we'd be holding our dollars up. She'd be going, Santana.
How many dollars did she give Santana?
I gave her 6 that I know of. Could have given her more. And then there was 6 other girls with us. Who knows?
Did he dance on your table?
Don't ask me.
Were y'all here? Were y'all at this?
Yes.
Okay.
Kim is telling all the truth.
Okay.
It's completely true.
This was exactly what happened?
Yes. Right when she first got there, she's like, oh, I don't think I like this place. Oh, I don't want to get in one of those hot seats. No. Y'all don't promise me you're not going to do one of those things. After she'd been there a little while and she'd seen Santana a couple times, she's like, where's that hot seat? But she just kissed him on the cheek. So everything was fine.
On the cheek?
Yes. But she still thought it was very nice. On the cheek.
How much money did you donate to the cause?
I gave her $2 or $3 to put.
Put what?
In there.
Put what?
put somewhere.
Okay. All right. Were you present?
No, I was not at the bachelorette party, but
do you regret it?
Tracy has won the award this year. We've had this ongoing, people that get married, we're giving out awards for the ugliest wedding gift, and Tracy so far has won the prize with the famed unicorn.
The unicorn?
Famed unicorn.
Tell me about this.
She received a note and a gift from some people that have known her through her past and a girl that took ballet lessons with her, yet she cannot seem to remember who these people are. And they sent her a lovely unicorn. It's a wedding gift made in Mexico.
Good. Okay. Yeah. Okay, hi.
Hi.
Summer camp.
Well, I can't really remember. It's been a long time since summer camp, so I'm sort of having a difficulty remembering any real tales to tell on Tracy. But she, you know, Tracy's come to visit me in New York a number of times. I live in Manhattan. She's been up to visit me a number of times.
Do they have a Lemon Peel in New York?
No, they don't. There's a place called, I guess it's Chippendales in New York.
Have they been to Chippendales? Have y'all been to Chippendales?
No, I didn't take her there. Oh. I didn't take her. I thought that, you know, and there are more interesting, you know, artistic places to go, and Tracy certainly has that streak in her, so.
Okay. Who's married?
Just me.
Just you. Okay, well, we've already gotten those words, so we won't do that. Any best wishes or really?
I just wish them all the happiness in the world, and that every day is even more beautiful than the day before.
Okay.
Tracy, I hope that y'all have a wonderful marriage. I know I've given you a great brother as a husband, and I hope that y'all are always as happy as Rick and I are.
Okay. Is there anything that Tracy ought to know?
Can't think of anything about Ken. I hope he's neater than he was growing up. She seems to think he is.
Okay. Any best wishes?
Well, anything I say is sort of at the risk of being really sappy and sentimental, which Ken sort of like got after me about doing once before when I gave him their wedding gift, but I really do sincerely hope that they are very happy together and have a really long life together.
Okay, good.
I'm getting married in October, Tracy, and I promise you I will not stress. And if I do, you'll be the first person I call, and I will scream to you like you have screamed to me and everybody else. But it's understood. This is your day. It turned out perfectly, and I hope mine does too. But I hope you guys have the best of luck.
Good. Everybody get real close together and give me a wave goodbye.
Bye. Happy honeymoon.
Bye.
Have a good time.
Well, we'll put this out here. Did y'all enjoy the wedding?
Oh, we had a wonderful time.
Good, good. Any best wishes you'd like to convey to Tracy and Ken?
Yeah. Don't do it again. We had a good time, but don't do it again.
I'll second that.
How long have y'all been married?
37 years.
If you had to give them a word of advice, each of you, what would you tell them it takes to make a marriage work?
He gets up at 5:30 and she doesn't have to cook breakfast, and that works great. You like that?
I like that one.
Enthusiasm.
Who's the boss?
She is.
You agree with that?
I do. That makes it work, too.
Okay, great. Thank you.
As long as you know, got the lines of authority straight. She's the boss.
All right, good. Appreciate it very much. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Hi there.
Hi. We want to see you.
Well, go right ahead.
We want to say that thanks for the all good times that we've had this year.
Speak up.
Speak up.
20 more with Karen.
All right. Yes, and
okay, great. Thank you all very much.
Bye.
Good. Hi.
Wow, that's bright.
Wow, that's bright.
Get over here.
Put the vent on there.
You can stand beside him. He needs some moral support.
Well, I want to tell Tracy and Ken how to have a good marriage. Tracy knows Sue from way back when. And she wants a good marriage. Just be like Sue. It'll work out. We love you both.
What does it take to make a marriage work?
A lot of loving, understanding.
A lot of
trust. Don't argue.
Who's the boss?
It don't work.
I am.
Well, I say I am, but she knows who's the boss.
Okay, thank y'all very much. Appreciate it.
Bill Felder.
Sherry Felder.
Some people may not know who you are when they see this. You know, may go down the line somewhere.
Well, they should.
Y'all have a relative that was involved today?
That's correct.
Very dear daughter. Very sweetheart. She really is a beautiful bride.
Yes, she was.
How'd you enjoy the wedding?
Loved it. And I didn't cry.
Didn't cry?
I did not cry.
My camera says wrong.
I loved it and I didn't step on her train.
I noticed how you avoided that. You did a very good job of that.
Thank you. That would have made her cry.
Do you remember the first time y'all met Ken?
No.
Was there no formal bringing him home to meet mom and dad?
We're not very formal people.
Oh, okay.
We're real laid back.
All right, good. That's the best way to be sometimes. Absolutely.
And he's an easy person to be laid back with.
Yes.
I came out well in this deal.
I agree. Ken's great.
How long have y'all been married?
15 years, June 21st.
Okay. Give me a word of wisdom, a word of advice for the bride and the groom, each of you. What does it take to make a marriage work?
I have no idea.
Compromise.
Good, good. All right. She got you going yet?
Well, I would just say life's short. Don't make a big deal out of the little things. Remember how much you love each other.
Okay.
Hey, Dad. Just remember this day. Just remember this day.
Okay.
I'll get you through a lot.
Great. Any other best wishes?
I just think the
You're
wedding
You're still my baby. You're still my baby. You will always be my baby.
Open invitation for both of them to come to dinner?
Absolutely.
Good.
Absolutely.
Okay. Great. Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Sweetheart.
I'm ready.
If you haven't said anything you want to tell them, go ahead right now.
Good luck. Have a honeymoon.
Any good luck? Best wishes. Do them now.
Yes, we love you.
You're wonderful.
Any best wishes? Good luck. Any best wishes? Good luck. Do them now.
Good luck.
Hey, good luck. Good luck.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Yay, it's over.
We're going to get you out of there.
You look marvelous.
Bye, Tracy.
Happy honeymoon. Happy honeymoon. Don't do anything on it.
Everybody be ready. The groom just said is, where's all the guys?
Is that what he said?
What are you saying to do, jump out?
They've got on all their underwear, his underwear out of his bags.
Oh, God.
Where'd y'all get these, folks? Where'd y'all get these?
These are all Mr.
Knowles's. Out of his bag?
No underwear, no socks.
That boy's got no waist either.
You mean you didn't get the bridesmaids to do the others?
Let me tell you, he's mighty skinny, you know?
He's ridiculous.
That's what I'm
talking about. He's not going to wear these anymore.
Both of them underwear.
Don't let him see you do this.
Well, they're not looking at us.
Well, come on, leave.
I know, I'm ready to go.
Excuse me, guys. Move over, guys.
We're going. We have
we want to go, too.
We haven't gotten over the honeymoon yet. We want
to
go.
Go, Barbara, go.
You're going to back down a little bit further and get these other guys, too, aren't you?
Yeah, that's what I'm going to try to keep them from seeing them right now.
Stretched out.
these are 36s. These are 36s.
Get out of the blue cow.
Say goodbye, guys.
It's arrested.
I'm not nervous.
You take care. You took something for your nerves?
Yeah. Took something real fast for my nerves.
There you go.
Guys, I've heard a whole lot of stories about the bachelorette party, but I haven't heard about the bachelor party. Where was that?
Oh, Troy. Troy, come up here and tell us
Nobody's
about the bachelor
really told
party.
Me about yeah, the bachelor party.
But no, we got the NBC News Network
this.
Right here.
I haven't heard much about the bachelor party. I heard a lot about the bachelor party.
Saturday night at a Grover, so I couldn't go.
Troy, give us some information on that. Where are they
going? Don't make me spot like this.
Troy, I heard there was a
confidential.
I heard there was routine problems involved in that. So we need to.
Only in the eyes of Tracy.
Were y'all?
Hey, bachelor parties, guys talk, and it doesn't go on tape.
Well, just give me this. Where did you go for a bachelor?
Basic strip joint, stuff like that.
Basic strip joint.
What's a basic strip?
Whereabouts?
The Cheetah 3, or what are we talking about?
Basic strip joint.
Gold Club.
Gold Club.
Who did y'all do the same with which the girls did to Tracy? Did y'all bankroll Ken for this?
What did the girls do to Tracy?
They bankrolled him.
I can't hear him.
Did y'all bankroll Ken the same way that they bankrolled Tracy?
Bankroll?
They kept giving her money.
Oh yeah.
To do whatever she wanted with it.
We had like a stack of ones.
And there's this black girl, man. You should be nice.
Right?
Her name wasn't Santina, was it?
It was Chablis.
Chablis. Okay, Chablis.
Chablis number three.
At the Cheetah 3.
You got it.
Okay, got it. Okay.
Three.
A part time.
Were you a part of this?
I don't know anything about it.
You wish you were a part of
it. I'll tell you what, he had the idea of stealing the underwear. This was all the doctor's plan. Steal the underwear and the socks and dress up in front of this.
I want to ask you why y'all were so prejudiced on this thing.
Now
it seems to me that y'all took his, but nobody messed with her bag.
That's the bride.
Because I had the bride. The bridesmaids.
Miss Knowles. Miss Knowles would not give me the information on where the luggage was.
He knew where the luggage was.
I had to go to.
Say goodnight, guys.
Night, guys.
In front of Amy, marriage is great, but you need to go out with the guys once a month and get plastered. That's the only way you can make it.
Any particular place you would suggest they go?
Any place that has naked women and a lot of beer.
How'd you enjoy the wedding?
It was great.
Beautiful, wasn't it? Any words you'd like to convey to the bride and the groom? Any best wishes or words of wisdom?
Oh, it's not very good to advise people at that age unless they ask for it, but I do hope they have a very happy life together. They seem to know how to work together, which is very important.
If you had to offer them a word of advice on what does it take to make a marriage work, what would you tell them?
I'd say, like I told Ken, keep the Lord in it.
Great. Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, size what?
Size mama. I got the
informant.
What?
Yeah.
She needs to buy Ken larger size shorts. We couldn't hardly fit in those things.
He's not going to be able to wear those anymore. Now you know why Miss Knowles likes me. Put some ugly things in there, dirty movies or something, you know, so I could have a good time on the wedding.
Okay. As the bride and the groom have already left, any little feelings going through your minds right now? Any feelings?
Excitement, and at this point, it's fun.
I told Ken I was glad he's gone. I sat down with Ken at the wedding and told him that I loved him and how good we felt about him and what he was doing with his life, and that we were looking forward to he and Tracy having a wonderful life together, and that they had to pull real hard to do as well as Wes and I.
Good, good. Y'all been married how long?
27 years.
27, be 28.
Okay, I'd like to ask this question. Sure. What does it take to make it work?
Work.
Yeah, work.
You have to work at it every day. You have to give and love
and being each other's best friend.
Good, good. Is there anything that Tracy ought to know about Ken?
She's probably...
She just found out that he has tacky underwear.
That's true. I don't think I saw any plain underwear in that group. It all had something on it, didn't it?
Yeah. I didn't know he wore boxes.
Any best wishes you'd like to convey to him? Any last thoughts?
Oh, we wish them that, you know, your life is rich with family and things, but that's all glued together with the richness of good friends.
Good, good. Daddy?
I told Ken I hoped he made his second meeting before I did. But that we love him and Tracy, and I know they're going to have a great life together, and that's what it's all about.
Good. Is there an open invitation for them to come to dinner?
Sure.
If
anytime.
They call first.
Great. Okay. Thank you all very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Good.